Welcome to part two of our Events in FMOD Studio tutorial video. This time we'll be continuing from our previous video by using the remaining sounds in both timeline sheets and parameter sheets. In our previous video, we added environmental sound to an action sheet. Now we want to make an event to play our highlight sounds, as well as an event to play our bird sounds. First, let's create an event to play our highlights. There's a number of ways to create an event like this, but for this video, we're going to make a linear timeline to place all the sounds on. So we go back to the Events tab, right-click, and select the 3D timeline from our pre-made event. Let's call this one Highlights. You can see that because we selected the 3D timeline option, the event has been loaded with a timeline sheet ready for us to use. So let's drag one of our sounds onto the timeline. If we press play now, you'll see the playback position starts moving from left to right, just like a standard door playback. In a timeline sheet, the playback position will continue until FMOD Studio knows there's no more sounds to play. So to make our timeline sheet play for longer, we can just drag more sounds onto the timeline sheet like so. If we press play again, you'll see that the playback position now continues until the end of the second sound. If we just repeat this process, we can make a timeline sheet that goes for as long as we need it to. Now that we've added all of our highlight sounds to our timeline sheet, we have this. But we want this sound to loop as well, just like our ambience event. The difference here is that we want this entire region to be looped, not each individual sound. In other words, we want the playback position to return to the start of the sheet once it moves past the last sound. We can do this using the logic tracks. We'll have a dedicated video focusing on everything you can do in the logic tracks coming soon. But for now, just right-click in the black area here, and select Add Loop Region. You can then set the left side of this region to the start of the timeline sheet by left-clicking and dragging here. Then we want to move the right side of the loop region all the way to the end of the last sound, like this. Now, when the playback position reaches the right side of the loop region, it will jump to the left side. To test this, left-click and drag on the timeline and you can reposition the current placement of the playback position to a place near the right side of the loop region. And now if we press play, you'll see the playback position will play the last sound as it's currently underneath the playback position, then jump back to the start of the sheet where the left side of the loop region is. Now let's create a new event for our bird sounds. For this event, we have two different sounds and I'd like to be able to change between them in-game using a single event. We can use a parameter sheet to do just this. Let's navigate back to the Events tab, right-click in the blank space and select New Event this time. Call this one Birds. This time, however, you'll notice there's no sheet yet. This is because we created a blank event. To add a sheet, you can just left or right click anywhere in the sheet's workspace. We want to add a parameter sheet to our birds event. To do so, just left or right click, select Add Parameter Sheet, then select New Parameter. A parameter is a value that the game engine can change to control various aspects of an event or multiple events. We'll go over all the details in this window in a later video, but for now, just change the name to Intensity and click OK. You can now see our newly created parameter sheet called Intensity. Let's add a sound to our parameter sheet by returning to our Assets tab and dragging in our first bird sound. Note that on the parameter sheet, when we press play, the playback position no longer moves forward. However, we still get a linear representation of the sound's playback position, indicated here. As this is a parameter sheet, we control the playback position with the connected parameter. In our case, this parameter is the one that we made earlier, intensity. If you change the value of intensity by left-clicking here and dragging up or down, you'll see the playback position will update accordingly. This means we can control when a sound plays simply by adding a sound to the parameter sheet at a given value's position, then setting the parameter to that value. In this case, we want the louder bird sound to play when the intensity is set to a higher value. So we can take our louder bird sound and drag it onto the parameter sheet at 0.9. If we now set the parameter intensity to 0.9, you'll see the new bird sound plays instead of the old one. If we now set the intensity all the way back to 1, however, the new bird sound won't play. This is because there is nothing underneath the playback position. To fix this, we need to resize our sound to cover the values at which we want it to play. To resize the sound, move your mouse over the left or right side of the instrument box to see your cursor change to the resize tool. Just click and drag in the direction you want to resize the sound. Now you can see if we press play while intensity is set to 1, that the sound plays as it's now under the playback position. Now that you've got a strong foundation in understanding how events and sheets in FMOD Studio work, stay tuned for our next video where we discuss instruments in FMOD Studio. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell to stay up to date with all our new videos.